Hi, welcome back to Learn with Loli. Today I am so excited to share with you a book that I picked up a couple years ago and recently was skimming through again. It is called Spark by Dr. John J. Ratey, and it is all about how exercise actually helps us to improve the way that we learn and think and develop. So I had to share some of this stuff with you because it is so engaging and is so relevant. And even though it goes outside of my field of educational psychology, Dr. Ratey is a medical doctor, so he knows exactly what he's talking about. The first thing that blew my mind and I found to be amazing is that exercise can actually help us develop new brain cells. There's been a lot of research that has now been debunked saying that when you are born with all of the brain cells you're ever going to have in your life, and those atrophy or die over the course of your lifetime. What Dr. Ratey points out is that when you exercise, your brain releases hormones and neurotransmitter, for example, insulin-like growth factor, and that actually allows your brain to begin the process of regenerating new brain cells. Another reason that exercise is amazing for your brain is because it actually prepares and encourages brain cells to bind to one another. If you've ever tried to learn something new, like a new language or an instrument, you know that if you don't practice or keep up with that thing, you slowly start to lose your ability. That's because your neurons slowly start to detach from one another and decay because they're not being used. But what Dr. Ratey is saying is that when you exercise, it actually preps these neurons that are in your brain to connect, to bind to one another, to be strengthened to one another, so that you're actually able to retain information and learn more quickly. The other really cool thing that he says is that the new neurons that you gain through more complex movements of exercise, for example, dancing or yoga or sports, something that has coordination and a skill that you have to learn, which is a little bit more advanced than running or walking, those neuron pathways and neuron connections and new brain cells can actually be reused by your brain to help you in other areas of thinking. That's why people say that kids who learn piano are also so good at math. The biggest reason for that is because your brain is able to use the new neuron pathways that were created by playing the piano and learning a new instrument and reutilize those and recycle those neurons to apply them to something else, such as math. Another reason that exercise is great for your brain is because it also increases the release of a neurotransmitter called norepinephrine. Norepinephrine actually improves your attention, your perception, your motivation, and your arousal, meaning that you're able to understand information more quickly, you're more focused on the information that's in front of you, you're more stimulated by it, and you're better able to focus on it. In addition to that, exercise also increases the release of dopamine, which is another neurotransmitter. And this hormone improves your learning, your satisfaction, your attention, and your movement. It literally helps you to acquire information quicker and then to feel satisfied with your efforts afterwards. Dopamine is also called the feel-good hormone, so it will also improve your mood tremendously. The last neurotransmitter that I want to talk about that really increases with exercise is serotonin. Serotonin is a neurotransmitter that improves your mood, but it also decreases your impulsivity, your aggressiveness, and your anger. If you've ever taken antidepressants or know anyone who has, then you might be a little bit more familiar with serotonin, because many antidepressants focus on keeping high levels of serotonin in your body. That's how amazing this neurotransmitter is. Now, there are so many different reasons that people have varying levels of serotonin in their body, but what Dr. Ratey is saying is that exercise will help you naturally increase the level of serotonin in your body, help you learn, help you acquire new knowledge, and help you improve your mood, your focus, and decrease your anger and tension. Lastly, exercise helps your brain by allowing your body to relax. A lot of the time, if we are feeling fidgety or tense, if we're tapping our fingers a lot or shaking our legs a lot, it's because we have pent-up energy that our body has not yet released. Exercising helps you release that energy so that when it's time for you to sit down and to focus, your body is calm. Your body is in a state of rest, even though your mind is hard at work. Now, Dr. Ratey also recommends that people exercise right before their most difficult subject or their hardest test or where they need their brain power the most. This is because when you exercise, your blood flow is shunted away from your brain so that your body can focus on using it for your muscles, for accelerating, for movement, for muscle contraction, all types of things. But after you're done exercising, that blood flow rushes back up to your brain. Those hormones are being released and circulated around your body, and your brain is fired up and ready to go. Like I said, this was an amazing book, and I highly recommend that you read it if you have the time. There are different chapters on anxiety, on women's health, which includes pregnancy, as well as menopause, PMS, and PMDD. It's relevant whether you're in high school, whether you're in college, graduate school, whether you're a parent, because it talks about not only the need for us to exercise, but why it's important. Not for appearance or aesthetic or to be more attractive, which is really common to see in our society, but for the neurological benefits, for the benefits for your brain, for your organs, for your functioning, and for learning. Thank you so much for watching this video. I hope that you enjoyed it. Please comment below if you're familiar with these concepts or if you have any other book recommendations that I should be looking to, because this research is fascinating. If you're interested in working with me one-on-one, please go to my website, learnwithloli.com, and sign up for your free 30-minute consultation session. Please like, subscribe, comment, and share this video if it has helped you, and I will see you next week.